Imagine you are a caveman in 20,000 BC who just invented bow and arrow. But before you can enjoy the glory of your invention, suddenly a time machine appears which looks like a blue police box. A guy pops out and says, "Welcome to capitalism. I am from the future where time machines have been invented and we are outsourcing work back in time. We know that you'll work for us at a price as low as a potato a day. So your next assignment is to make a smartphone called ePhone 420XYZ for a brand called Pineapple. Here is your advance for this month. We won't give any additional information and no excuses. The mental capacity of an upper paleolithic man is the same as modern day man. So get started." So what will you do now? How will you make a smartphone from scratch with just that much information? Remember, you will have to invent everything that has not been invented yet. Let's see. What is a smartphone even made of? It has electronic components, it has software, it has a body, and it will obviously need a cellular network and internet to function completely, and you will need it to test that the smartphone you made is working properly. So now you need to invent each of these components. Let's start with something that was primarily invented for watching cat videos, the internet. Wait, but to access the internet on smartphone, you need cellular network. So now let's establish a cellular network. So take some towers and then, wait, but do you know about signal processing? You'll need to invent the theory of signals and system first. Okay, let's invent that first. So a signal is basically a function of time or frequency, wait, mathematics. We haven't discovered anything in mathematics yet. We would need algebra and calculus. For all this, you will need a proper number system. This seems like a lot of work. Okay, let's start with something simple. Let's start with that circuit and stuff. So let's prepare the circuit board. To make the processor of the... Wait, who will invent circuit theory first? Again, you will need all the mathematical tools here too. And guess what? You will need to discover electricity and all the physical laws governing it. Wait, but we haven't discovered even the basic physics yet. This is even more work. Software seems easy. So let's start writing the code. Write printf. Wait, how can we be writing the code yet? We haven't even invented theory of computation. And then we will need to invent data structures and algorithms. And then... Smartphones are pretty complex system. In system theory, there is a phenomena called emergence, which simply means when lots of simple things together makes up a complex thing with new properties. The YouTube channel Kirkzat has made a pretty impressive video on this topic. You should check it out.
An ant is pretty stupid.
Seriously, Kirkzat? You don't care about the feelings of an ant? This ant needs a therapy now. Anyways, the point is when generally people try to explain the phenomena of emergence, the phenomena which explains how stupid things become smart together, they generally use example of ants or neurons and simple things like that as stupid thing, which makes up complex thing. What if we take humans as the stupid or simple thing? What are humans emerging into? Let's go back to our tree of inventing the mobile phone. If we start attaching the people who led to the development of each node in this tree, we can see the contribution of individuals throughout the history required to get to this point. For each component and its pre-components, millions of people invested their entire lives working on these components. Some pretty big names are here. And you wanted to make everything from scratch. These geniuses invested their entire life on it. But wait, are these geniuses the only player in the game? Take Newton here for example. He could not have lived on his own. He needed teachers and books to learn, but even more fundamentally, needed food to survive, shelter to live, clothes to wear. He needed someone to cook the food. To cook the food, someone had to sell vegetables, like a vendor. For that, a farmer was needed to grow vegetables. Newton needed a network of humans. Even though Newton was an extremely important part of the history, he needed other humans. He was dependent on other humans, and those humans were in turn dependent on other humans. This is a very deep interdependence. Cook gave Newton food, Newton gave Cook some laws of physics. I mean, he gave humanity the laws of physics and calculus, which more people further used to give rest of the humanity something like a smartphone. Now think of humanity as a network of brains, where brains transmit ideas by speaking or writing or publishing research papers, writing stories, poems. A body is just a vessel in which brains live, and each brain is supported by a network of brains to fulfill its needs. Each brain transmits an idea into the network, and the network further processes the ideas. This network invented a smartphone by studying the universe, processing the information, making tools and discoveries to build it, and then finally makes it. This goes for everything humanity has ever come up with. No single brain is capable of producing the achievements of the entire network. Each brain provides some value, big or small, to the network. Some brains in the network are destructive also, which holds back the progress of the network. However, most brains have been productive. That's why this network has come so far in terms of development. Also, this network doesn't have a lifespan. It will live as long as humanity survives. Even though a brain in a network dies, the entire network called humanity keeps the idea alive by further transmitting it, reusing it, modifying it. So transmit good ideas that power the network. The idea doesn't need to be something big. Write something, tweet something, go make a YouTube channel and talk about things you like, even though people can't take your accent.